in his fifth season at Alabama, fourth year as the primary defensive coordinator, finally his year, finally his time, finally his moment to show that he is a big-time defensive coordinator. People have had mixed feelings about him. Some have said, hey, he's young, he's growing, he's getting better, give him some time. Others have said, no excuses, Bama players look lost, they don't know what they're doing. Pete don't know what he's doing, get him out of here. But I think this is his moment. This is the year he's been building to, he's been stacking to. And during Sunday's media day, he was talking to reporters, spoke with a lot of swagger, a lot of confidence, even dropped a few cuss words here and there because Pete knows what he's got this year. Pete Golding knows what he has this year. And I think he's finally about to have his year as a defensive coordinator. I think he's finally about to have his year with this defense being either top three, top five, or maybe even the number one defense in all of college football. And the three reasons why Pete Golding is about to have his year. Number one, you know, Bama's got a healthy defense all across the board. No mishaps thus far. No crazy stuff didn't happen thus far. Hopefully it continues that way. So healthy defense. Number two, Bama's got leadership on all levels of the defense. For the first time in Golding's 5 years at Alabama, every line of defense, you got a leader. You got somebody on that leadership council. You got somebody that the whole team trusts and rides behind. You got somebody that when they speak, everybody listens. You got somebody on that defense that know exactly what they're doing. So leadership on all three levels of the defense. And then last but not least, I think Pete Golding is just prepared to unleash every dog at an opposing quarterback. He's prepared to unleash all of the crazy, all of the creatures and opposing quarterbacks this upcoming season. Starting this off, number one, Bama's got a healthy defense this year. I mean, think about this. Ever since Pete Golden became the primary defensive coordinator, Alabama's had an injury issue defensively. Whether it was 2019 in fall camp where Dylan Moses, Joshua McMillan, bang, both of them went down. 2020, Dylan Moses playing through injuries. Malachi Moore has the stress fracture in his back there. Back spasms, couldn't play the last few games of a 2020 season. You know, injuries there at those two spots. And if you look at 2021, I mean, Chris Allen goes down first game of the season against Miami. And then you have injuries to Josh Jobe and Jagan Armour Davis. I mean, Malachi Moore dealt with shin splints last season. So you had injuries in those in each of the last three seasons for Pete Golden. Injuries. And injuries to important players. Now, everybody healthy. Everybody healthy. All of the main key cogs, the main key leaders, the main key voices. Everybody healthy. And when you have a defense functioning with everybody at full go, it makes life for a defensive play caller easier. And now that play caller knows I got all of my tools in the tool shed. I don't have to go and find something different. No, all of my tools that I'm counting on in this tool shed to be great, they're all here. So it's number one. Number two, Bama's got leaders at every level of the defense. At the defensive line, you got a Byron Young. You got a Justin Aboigbe. You got a DJ Dale. They've all played a lot of football. I know you got Jameel Burrows, Jaheim Otis, Jamarion Latham, guys like that, and then other guys like Damon Payne and Tim Keenan III and those guys. But Byron Young, Justin Aboigbe, DJ Dale, all playing a lot of football. Leaders on that defensive line. Experience. At the next level, you've got Will Anderson, Henry To'o, they played football. Jalen Moody in his fifth year at Alabama. He's got experience in the system. Dallas Turner had a big year last year as a freshman. Now he's going to be a full-time starter. Chris Braswell, a guy that, you know, experience within the system. Now he's going to have a shot. And the secondary, Jordan Battle, DeMarco Helms, both back, leaders, played a lot of football. Brian Branch, Malachi Moore, back, played a lot of football. Kyrie Jackson, Kool-Aid McKinstry, got experience last year, will build off that. Eli Ricks, I get it, not experienced at Bama, but comes over from LSU where he played 16 games with the Tigers. So the point being, at every line of defense, Pete Golden's got like a coach on the field in terms of a player that's got experience. And everybody knows how that player rolls. So that's number two. And for number three, Pete's going to unleash everything to the quarterback. He's coming at quarterbacks this season. He's talked about it. Hey, we're going to get all of our rushers on the field. We got to do great on first and second down. So that third down, all of our fast, mean, nasty, I'm going to take your head off guys can get on the field and do what they do. Go after the quarterback. And those guys, like Dallas Turner, like Will Anderson, like Chris Braswell, like Byron Young. Hey, I got a chance to speak with Henry To'o. He said, I'm going to get in the sacks competition. I worked on my pass rush moves all offseason. I'm going to be getting some sacks. I'm going to be dropping some quarterbacks to the dirt myself. So here we go. He goes and said last, he mentioned Sunday, we did not get the job done last year. We did not meet the ultimate goal last year. We did not meet our standard last year. We did not win the national championship last year. And that still hits in our gut. We got to get back there. We got to get back there. And it starts with having that defense that's elite all across the board. This is the first time in 5 years where Bama Nation, Bama consumers of Bama football, we can truly judge Pete Golding now. This is the season where you can truly judge, you can truly evaluate everybody healthy from top to bottom. You got experience in every line of this defense. And number three, you got the guys that you can send out for the quarterback to make the quarterback's life a living nightmare. This is Pete Golding's year to say, I have it. And every Alabama fan will have their eyes on him wondering, does he have it?